David Benavides is just 13 years old. He trains at the Wildcard Boxing Club in Hollywood, sparring with professionals and amateurs and holding his own. He's way better than his young age. In fact, he's knocked out already a few people. But kids in school and those who meet him have no idea that in front of them stands a true boxing talent. He's also the younger brother of boxing star Jose Benavides Jr.
That's David.
Your dad told me that you were boxing when you were 3 years old.
Yeah.
And you were knocking people out. You're a knockout artist. How did you get so good?
Well, just seeing my brother train, I wanted
Jose
to be like him.
Benavides.
Yeah, Jose Benavides. I just wanted to be like him.
When are you going to be professional? 14? Next year?
Maybe.
You see him going pro if he likes it?
You know, he has a lot of talent. We'll see that. You know, if he really wants to do that, you know, definitely he has to work hard. And I think he has a pretty good chance, but he has to decide if that's what he wants to do. We'll definitely, you'll see a little bit about him a little bit later.
So that's David, he's running to the corner.
Yeah.
Are you in his corner?
Yeah, I'm in his corner. That's when I was younger.
So that's young David?
Yeah.
How good is your dad as a trainer? What would you tell people?
I think he's gonna go, hopefully he'll make it in the Hall of Fame as one of the greatest trainers.
I hope other people don't notice, 7-time national champion, Golden Glove Nash, that doesn't happen. Your dad is the one who started him and stayed with him till now.
Maybe I want him to do the same with me. Maybe he can do the same.
So when is his next fight?
His next fight, we're working on the weight a little bit to drop a little bit of weight. Hopefully in the middle of this year, you know.
What do you think about your brother as a fighter?
I think he's going to be one of the greatest too. I like how he does his jab.
4-0 before knockout.
4-0 before
knockout. Keep it up.
Yeah.
Here, that's David. That's his brother, David Benavides. He was like about 6 years old, I believe, maybe.
Was he boxing?
Yes, he was boxing, and all these kids, I trained all these kids, and all these kids were national champions, world champions also. I also had some girls boxing. And I was the one in Arizona that kind of had more champions at that time, you know?
You were the Freddie Roach of Arizona.
I was the Freddie Roach in Arizona.
So there you have it, future boxing star David Benavides. In Los Angeles, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting. Every day when Manny Pacquiao arrives to the Wildcard Boxing Club in Hollywood for his training camp, the club shuts down and everyone is asked to leave. Except 13-year-old David Benavides, who's working out with his dad, Jose Benavides. And I caught up with him.
Again. Big one in my right. Under. Do it again. Come on, angle up. Once you look. Under. Body. Hook. Right hand. Do it again. Once you look. Under.
Cool is it to be the only kid in the world to work out at the same gym when Manny Pacquiao's working out?
It's crazy, like. 2 months ago, I wouldn't even think I'd be here training with Manny, like in the same gym as Manny Pacquiao.
And now, the gym's closed, and you're the only kid in the gym working out, the only one.
It's cool.
Got it, girl. Good. Good.
Give me 1 minute.
Prediction on Manny's fight?
I think Manny Pacquiao's gonna knock him out.
How many rounds?
I give Claudia like 6 rounds at most.
David is not the only boxer in the family. Of course, his older brother, Jose Benavides Jr., is a boxing prodigy. What can you tell me about him?
¿Qué le puedes decir de mí? ¿Qué puedes decirle?
Oh, esa. Bueno, para empezar es el papá de. ¿En español? Para empezar es el papá de la que en 3-4 años va a ser la nueva superestrella del boxeo.
Número uno.
Número uno, 3-4 years. Number one, Jose Benavides Jr. World champion.
All right, what do you say now?
He's trying to say that, you know, like in about 2-3 years, he's going to be a world champion. Hopefully, he'll be a four-time world champion. You know, I do have a lot of people like him, you know, that are supporting us. I do appreciate it, and, you know, everybody that, you know, seeing this, you know, I really want to thank them, you know. Thank them for everything that they
Muchos gracias.
Support.
De nada, de nada.
He's a veteran here at this gym. He's been here since they opened.
He told me the other day he saw you.
Everybody sees me. I'm like, yeah. I'm like, Pacquiao.
Under. 13-year-old David Benavides working out alongside Manny Pacquiao. In Los Angeles, I'm Eli Sekbak, reporting.
Hello, vete un poquito más para el medio. No me mires, no, vete más para el medio. Listo.
Like 6'2",
6'2". He's skinny for his height, and he spars the best of the best. Tell me about him and Triple G in there.
Oh man, Triple G, Triple G, my respects, man. You know, I didn't know a Triple G at that time when we went to Big Bear. He's training with Abel Sanchez up there.
really nice person, man. Really, man, genuinely.
Everybody loves Abel. I haven't heard one person say something bad about
him. Yeah, Abel and Triple G, man. Triple G, as a matter of fact, invited us over to have dinner. Man, he cooks really good. The food was delicious. And, you know, the first time that he sparred with them, man, David told me, man, my arms hurt. This guy hits really hard. So I told him, well, you know, I mean, we're not going to spar him no more, you know. I don't want you to get hurt. But he says, no, let me get in there one more time. And
your son's tough.
G, you know, took it easy on him the second time. But then David got a lot of confidence. And then Triple G is like, man, you know, this kid, you know, I think he learned a lot from Triple G also. And then, you know, they were going at it, you know, real good. And Triple G told me, man, this kid is really helping me a lot. And David was learning so much about him too, you know, that, man, it was a great sparring.
I know one sparring partner that turned down $1,500 because he said after he sparred him one time, he had enough. About Triple G, he said his jab gives you brain damage.
I heard, you know, that a lot of people that Abel would fly some people over and then they would just quit, you know, go back, you know.
Robert Garcia always tells me Kelly Pavlik hits very, very hard. Your son and Kelly was very good sparring.
Yeah, you know, like I said, you know, too, I always get nervous, you know, but after Triple G, man, I don't get nervous with nobody, you know. He gave me a lot of confidence and... I can see, you know, at the same time, I pay real good attention to him, real careful. But Triple G is the best that we have sparred, you know, and he hits really hard now, you know. I'm really confident when he spars other people, you know, because I know what he could do, you know. But at the same time, I'm paying real attention, real careful. I'm being real careful with him.
Pasito ahí, más para un paso. Ahí está, parado. No te enseñes tan parado. No, bien, todo bien, todo bien. Toma el gol.
There we go. Come on, Blanco.
A los lados, Blanco. No se me quede ahí instalando. Cuerpo siempre.
Cuerpo.
How are you feeling now, Dave?
I feel good. I'm a little tired, but I think we did pretty good. And we need to get in the gym more to work more on our stamina, but yeah, I think we did pretty good.
How cool is it to get in there and mix it up with this guy right here?
It's like a dream come true, man, a world champion. I actually beat my brother's record.
Doing good.
Hey, this kid, keep an eye on this kid. He's going to be top dog. He's going to be champ. Mark my words.
Thank you.
Keep it up. Keep the hard work, kid.
He said, Kelly Pavlik said he will be champ. What do you say about that?
I say he's correct. Smart guy.
Smart guy.
Well, I'm pretty excited. You know, hear that from Kelly Pavlik. It's just great. You know, hard work pays off. You know, words can't even describe, you know. I mean, I always tell David, you know, work hard, you know, and it'll pay off. So, you know, like I said, you know, just hearing it from Kelly Pavlik, man, it's a big support.
It takes a lot of guts to get in there with anybody, let alone with someone with a record with 37 and 232 knockouts.
Exactly. You know what a lot of people say, they say that I'm crazy, you know, but, you know, I know what I have. You know, I know that, you know, he works hard. You know, he takes care of himself. And, of course, you know, I'm his father. I'm always going to take care of him.
year with Jose Benavides, one of the best trainers in the business. Jose, how many titles, national titles, did your son Jose Jr., Jose Benavides Jr., win as an amateur?
I think like about, I said like about 15, somewhere around there.
What's his record now as a pro?
16 and 13 knockouts.
That's crazy.
Well, unbelievable. You know, I was running this morning and I was thinking about, man, time goes so fast. You know, I remember when he was fighting his first fight. Actually, you were there in Vegas and you were recording. And I was looking at David too, you know, how his face was real big, you know, it was real
chubby. He was a kid. He was 12.
Real chubby. And I didn't really notice, you know, that he was big, you know. And we go back and see those videos and, you know, we start laughing. Now he lost a lot of weight, you know, he's sparring
the likes of Triple G.
Yeah.
I remember he sparred this other fighter once, and I was walking with you guys at Hollywood Boulevard. Some guy that was fighting on HBO, I think he was from Uzbekistan or somewhere.
Yeah, man, he's been sparring so many people.
He sparred Kelly Pavlik.
Kelly Pavlik.
He sparred Latif?
Yeah, Latif Coyote too, Kid Chocolate.
How old is your son?
The guy that sparred Kirkland, Japanese guy.
Yeah. You're something a number on him.
Yeah. So he, you know, yeah.
He knocked out Kirkland. He didn't spar him.
Yeah. No. David sparred that guy that knocked out Kirkland.
Great fighter, you know. I dropped him 3 times before. I knocked him out, and it just took everything from me because he was not going to give up. You know, I hit him with a few body shots in the last round. I hurt him. I seen the hands were coming down, so I seen the opportunity to throw a little combination of the head. First 2 punches I seen were hitting, so I just let it go. 6 more punches. I got the job.
18-0, 17 knockout three with your dad and trainer. What's it like to work with your son?
Oh man, you know, it's always been something that you can't even really explain. I work with other fighters, but it's just working with Jose Benavides Jr. and David Benavides is just special. It's something that, you know, I would not trade for anything else, you know. It's just great, great feeling.
How's Jose Jr. doing? People ask me all the time.
Yeah, he's doing good. He started training. I just talked to him like about a week ago. He's moving around and trying to get some condition, and hopefully pretty soon he starts boxing.
You're in the 160 division. 168. Who's right now the king of 168?
You know, there's a lot of champions right now. Sulder Ramirez is a champion. Who else? I think the dude from Germany just lost the WBA belt, and then of course the winner of Darrell and Anthony and Colin Smith. But you know, I'm looking to take over the division. I don't care who it is, I'm here to take over. You know, no matter what I had to go through, I'm working hard, so that's my plan.
You never know if you'll get a knockout when you step in the ring. But that knockout you had against Forky Medina just went viral, people were going crazy. Tell me about coming home the next day and realizing, wow, this video is just all over the world now.
You know, I really didn't realize how big it was really going to be until I got to Phoenix. You know, I went to the store and everybody's called David, and you know, it felt really good and, you know, really motivated me a lot to keep giving the people these types of knockouts in life.
Canelo Triple G, break it down.
Wow, that's going to be an exciting fight, man. I can't wait. I think, you know, I'm going to go with Triple G. I think he's an animal. He's a strong fighter. It's going to be a great fight, don't get me wrong, but I think I'm going to go with Triple G. I think he's going to destroy him. I think he's going to knock him out.
Your son David told me the same thing. What do you tell me?
Yeah, I think Triple G's going to... I think it's going to be a good fight. I don't know if he might get the knockout or not, but I have Triple G.
How many rounds did you share the ring with Triple G sparring?
I like the last camp, at least 40.
And it's very hard to spar him because people who spar him usually get sent home early, crack ribs. You had a lot of success with him. What was the secret? Is it just your instincts, your reflexes, or you're just very tough? Just,
you know, when you fight the left and me, when you spar him, I'm on high alert all the time. My reflexes have to be at the best because if he hits you, he's gonna hurt you. He is hard. Believe the hype behind the left and he is hard. And I can just imagine how he feels with those little gloves, but. You know, just being on high alert, you know, your instincts have to be at 100. So
they've described his power compared to other fighters.
You know, other fighters, they just have really that, they have to hit you clean to get hurt. Well, for me, actually, Golovkin, he pushes through with every shot. And then he throws shots that are like, it's like a left hoop, but he throws at the top.
Looping, right? Yeah.
Yeah, looping. So he has a lot of tricks in his game.
And it doesn't matter where he hits you. If you block, he hits all.
And you still feel
it. Oh, yeah. Man, you can
I mean, I haven't gotten in there with them, but I can see the reaction, the, you know, the faces.
I've seen the sparring partners wear a body shield. Dude, yeah. Do you wear one too?
No, I don't wear a body shield.
Okay. But everybody else does.
I kind of wanted to go in there until I can't. I want to feel a body shield.
All right, tell all the fans where to follow you guys.
Follow me at Instagram at David_Benavides_300.
Jose, Facebook, Jose Benavides. Instagram, Jose Benavides Senior.